Okay, so carrying on from yesterday with the importer, the generators and importer functions registrars for importers. I got it tested yesterday. Now I need to kind of complete the process of changing it over, which means, first of all, let's go to distribute the YAML. Do we have him import functions? Yes, we do. Let's get rid of it. Bam, bam. And there that goes. We get rid of the add and remove importers from that. Currently have the set gen because what we're going to have to do is on the creation of it, we're going to have to. Do I even use that anymore? I don't think I do, but I do actually right here. Okay, I don't want to use this. And in fact, state importer shouldn't even be using this either, should it? So let's find those functions. Okay. Let's actually back up just a little bit. We'll keep this here. We want to start from the bottom or from the state importer. Import state. Da 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 da. Because it's inside of here that it's using importer generators from that. It's no longer using the internal one, actually. So this should go away. And so should these. Now we'll still have these functions that are going away. Okay, this is gone from here. We also need to remove the function call from here. Since there's no state associated to this anymore, we can actually just turn this into a loose function again, or free function. This is this right here. Mean, there's just no. Yeah, this just is. That's just that. Need that? No. Need that? Yes. And need that? Yes. Don't need that. Don't need that. Do we need that? No, we don't need that either. So, I'm pretty sure. trying to think about how to new importers. Which goes into importers on the way out. Still longer that. Back to the application. Get rid of that. Okay, we're still good here. Okay. So at this point, we can get rid of the import functions. From here. We definitely don't use those anymore. Make sure. Now I'm in a deep thought trying to okay. So now what I need to do is on the creation of this, I need to assign it. Let's make sure I'm not using that anywhere else, right? It's there as a function. It's there, and it's currently that's what it's doing there. So we're going to do this right here. I need to make sure that these exist. And I need to make sure that these are the same. For the moment, we'll just do it like that. So we can at least get rid of the function from here. Mm-hmm. Still good. Yep. Okay, then what we need to do is we're going to have to, on the creation of this, we need to pass in this guy, this importer. So I need to pass in this. it's not that anymore. Okay, that also means we won't need, well, we still need this for the one we create at the end, unfortunately. Unless, move that. We, in the application, we're going to put this test registrar. That's coming from here. So we get the test generator there, YAML importer. I need to get rid of the set gen function. Don't need that anymore. It anymore. No. It's done automatically as part of the construction creation. And we can get rid of that one. Uh-oh, what did I do wrong? Oh. Need to actually add the correct test generator into the system. And then we're good again. Are these really the only functions? I'm wondering if they really need to be objects. Or if they can just really be free. They should actually probably be free for the moment. Well, okay, actually, that's one thing I do need to do. I need to figure out how to kind of replace this with something a bit smarter. So let's add everything we have right now. I need a better way, a smarter way to get the generators. Because they're just throwing out this is a terrible idea. So in, let's say, import state, this is really it? That's all that's left? It's like barely even 200 lines. Yeah. Okay, right now we get generators. And then we iterate through the list. What we should probably be doing is we already know the two functions that we're going to be using. It's group, it's a full ID group and a system path. So really what I should be doing is I should have like a central thing that's honestly, this should be a free function. It's like this. And then it just goes through all of them by itself. So this function just going to go through all of these generators that we have. So we need to lock them up first. We need to go through. Doesn't really matter. It's a pointer anyways, so go through generators. That would basically be it. Don't do that. Don't do that. Equals, just create importer like that. Okay, realistically, it should be this, right? There we go. That makes a bit more sense. Get rid of this. Got an extra one in there somewhere. Becomes that. Okay, so that's safer. Still not really great. Why are we here? Do I have line 144? Okay. Don't remember having this. File must be gone now. So if I go back down to application, test generator, we have the YAML importer. Okay. That's what we have here, we'll put in now. So what we got, importers. Not too great right now. What does this do right now, actually? Does this even do anything? I want to check, because I'm pretty sure right now it's still kind of sitting at the point where it just kind of loads up this and doesn't even process it, because I don't have a way of connecting it with resources. But that'll be next, or soon. Get everything else. Source pools. Okay. Why is this here? Don't know. It's gone now. Order. This is something I want to copy or move. I don't really know. Okay. Okay. And realistically, group translation is the only interesting thing which is added afterwards. I don't know. I'll just leave it. What I'll probably do is add import call. Rather than saying import func, it'll be like, 'cause that's short for function. Import call. Import func. Add import. Okay, it's kind of new folder for, or really, state YAML import calls. Do that function registrar. Thank you. grab this stuff out of the application, which is sitting up here somewhere. There you are. Core resource function registrar, which is a public of that. No, it's not final, it's just an override. Or rather, probably should be final. I mean, okay, is there really anything for bad if you add multiple registers? Like, what if you add the library multiple times through different things? I mean, that'd be bad. Because it's a map. Yeah, finals for the moment. Oh crap, I completely forgot to add the copyright. Had noticed all that old stuff as well. Alrighty then. I'll fix up the last one with this stuff as well. Sounds pretty okay. We know about that one. Then we need to go back to the application. We need to find add importers, import state. We need these YAML things. we want instead would be like include state YAML function registrar. Instead of this, we're going to add it. We don't actually remove it. Which means we don't need these anymore here. Making it just a little bit faster to build this file, especially on Windows. No negatives, still fine, still fine. Let's undo the last commit. Let's just have a look at it. Application, yeah. It's nowhere near as bad as it was. Actually, that is something I want to do. Is I need to run address sanitizer on it. Come on. Okay. That's probably something I've missed somewhere or other. No? Or maybe it just didn't come through because it was in GDB. That's more like it. All right. That's terrible, actually. There's a whole bunch of stuff I'm missing. So the model file importer plugin I gotta do eventually anyways. Where is this coming from? Okay, let's start at the beginning. 24 bytes in object allocated here. Import state, distributed that. Oh yeah, that makes sense, because I'm just creating them and then I don't actually... Okay, If we were not to just blindly create those. Wait, hold on. No. That actually does make sense because it's a unique pointer. It will be deleted. So something inside of it I'm creating and I'm not properly getting rid of. So yeah, there is a problem. So we're here, we're creating. In this definition, then going inside. This. We're creating something. We're creating a node. This doesn't make. We're creating a vector. I'm sorry. This is a vector of that, yeah? Yeah, okay. Is know this is being created eventually, so what we're going to do is CC, the blah blah blah, 2080. Okay, and you've got nothing because you don't exist yet. Okay, come back down to here. Great. Okay. Still 2080, right? I'll move on. Okay, maybe I shouldn't even. Maybe the problem is rather this is actually like not doing what I think it is. This is probably doing like a copy creation, a copy constructor, I should say, and then this pointer just flies off into nothingness, and that's my problem. For CO. Yeah. So it's probably just a mistake because I'm not done with this function yet. Kilobytes. Okay. So we're still kind of doing the same thing. Looks like. Not quite. This is actually from the one that's being loaded in from the shader loader, actually. Am I just not deleting it? I'm just not deleting this stuff. Okay. So I'm going to do, I'm going to leave that. I'm going to do that. I'm thinking I'm going to rechange, I'm going to change import functions to instead return, instead of returning bool, which is obvious whether or not you got something back out of it. Instead, it's going to be returning the actual pointer, which then you can put instantly into a unique pointer. And move on from there. So the import function I'm giving these guys is from the YAML importer. And it's this awful thing as well. And realistically, this should also be replaced with the ability to call into that faux importer base, or not that, it'd be the faux group data, so that it can then iterate through them. Okay, which one to do first? First, we will get rid of the memory issues before I delve in too much deeper. So we're going to change up these loaders to accept a different function type. Unless, is there anything else? Like, will I return like a standard error code in future? Or I can just do this and then return a standard error code in the future if it comes to that. But that would be later. For the moment, we're going to change it up to this. Go down to this. Over, close others. From here, it's that one, 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 that one. See, that actually makes a bit more sense. Damage P. Do the same thing here. Oh, no, this is the one that changed over to that. It's not quite there. Nope, nope, yes. So I was here, P mesh CI. Shader. Okay, that's those. Now I need to change the functions on the other side. From distributed YAML, I believe. Get resource, yes. So now it returns that instead. It also means changing up the importer base. Okay, and we get down here. Well. No, return true. Return true. What's going to happen instead is we're going to nature, we'll put brackets around it correctly. Problems? Yes, not really. Does it work? Appears to work. No real errors coming through. Okay. Let's see how bad the leaks are now. Well, it's down from 29 kilobytes to just one. Importer plugin, file importer plugin, and stuff outside of. So, yeah, we're basically back down to nothing again. Which is a plus in my book. So we'll do that. Then we'll add these guys. Something like that. I'm not really all that into no, I'll do it better. And safely so that's a bit better. Turn off address for the moment. Generate rebuild. Shrink down. Okay. So now what do I need? What are we doing? Just an hour? Okay. Pretty close to being able to start to rip these out into libraries of their own now. Quite close. However, I need to, because I'm not really happy about the requirement to bind, because these are, this is still a free object, or not a free object. This is a, like a, these functions are tied to an object right now, and I don't really, not so on board with that being a requirement. Especially since, like, it's focused on a single importer. It's not focused on what would eventually be the group data. I needed to go through the group data to get data now. I really do. But group data is, where is it? It's down here. So group data needs to know about resource, create info. Well, right now it needs to know about this. It really does. Unless I'm going to load everything at the start, all the definitions, which I don't want to have to do in case I have to create new definitions during runtime. So then I've kind of got a circular dependency. I don't really want to have to. I need to extricate these from each other somehow. Unless I change something to return like a void star pointer, and you have to know, but that's really starting to get on the dangerous side. I can't. No. I'm not going to let that happen. I honestly don't know. So it's been 1:10. I'll call it there an earlier night tonight. With some progress made. At least the importers stuff cleaned up and kind of officiated, something like that. Although they're probably going to change a bit more in the future. All right? Cheers.